Today we're going to make a birch bark canoe. This is an Athabascan styled canoe and it's made out of paper in this case, but looks identical to a canoe that's in the collection of the Alaska State Museum. So it has two small single bladed paddles to go with it, and you can see the internal framing. This is a pretty simple paper cutting exercise and coloring exercise. This is the inside of the canoe, and on the back is the outside framing of the canoe. There are directions right here across the top to follow, and it says to first consider coloring both the gunwale and the spruce root lashing on the gunwale here and here, as well as on the back side. I'm going to start on the back side. You can see that I've done some coloring already. This is actually part of the wood framing of the gunwale, and I'm going to color it a dark brown because I want it to look like that wood framing. And you'll notice I colored it there, and I'm coloring it here. My choice of colors being dark brown. And then I want to color some of this spruce root lashing. Some traditional colors for spruce root lashing were red, as well as black, as well as a blue-gray. And the blue-gray was made from blueberries. This red is from alder bark, and the black from charcoal. That's one way that it could be made. Okay. All right, I think I want to also make this a little bit brown. Spruce root lashing. I just color that in really easily. Spruce root lashing that's not dyed would be this brown color. And of course those come from the Sitka spruce trees. That's where they get the lashing. The roots are dug up and then peeled. And I'll go over on the other side, and I think I'll put a little bit of that same dyed red on the inside. It'll match. You'll notice those bolder ovals kind of indicate one across from the other where I'm at. And that's the same place that we're going to put thwarts or crossbars to hold the frame together. I think I've colored all I want to color on my canoe. Notice on our original canoe, this piece was a darker, different piece of birch bark than the sides. I'm going to leave that just like that. And so the next thing to do is to cut it out. And there's several pieces to cut out. There's the ribs here, as well as the paddles, as well as this frame. Okay. I'm going to cut off my directions and set them aside, so I have them to reference back to. And then I'm going to cut these thwarts down here, crossbars, out. Set those aside because I need those. And then I'm going to cut this canoe out. I don't want to lose my paddles either. Right in, you see these dotted lines? I have to cut through those dotted lines like that. And then cut this little, looks like a tab or a tongue. What we call them. I'm cutting right through those dotted lines on that edge. And then I'm going to continue to follow around the whole canoe frame. Again, we're getting where that tab is on the other end, the stern of the canoe, maybe the bow being the front and the stern being the back end of the canoe. In this case, they're pretty much identical, but sometimes the bow or the stern were slightly higher. Cut it out, and I'm going to look at the back, and it looks like it's cut out pretty well. Maybe I'll get rid of that little bit of white that's showing right there. I don't think it'll hurt the other side at all. So it looks pretty good to me. Okay. Now we're ready to fold this canoe together. You'll notice that this has a bottom frame kind of in it. This is the spruce root frame. And we're going to gently fold along that frame like this. Just fold it right to where that's cut. I'm going to gently fold this side too. It'll sit better. And these canoes were actually made, the real ones. This is they would be bending the bark around the frame after they set the frame on top of the bark. So, kind of starts to get a canoe shape. Then all we need to do is adhere this two pieces together. I'm going to use tape. That. Really simply. Just taping both sides. Just like that. I'm going to tape it right down to where that tab is. So just tape it there. Bring that tape around the other side. Just pinch it in. Just like that. Got a little bit sticking up, but I think I'll just bend that back in like that. So see, it's taped together. Now see this tab that's down here. I'm going to take that tab and bend it around either side like that. I'm going to set that down for a minute and cut some little pieces of tape for myself. This makes it a little bit easier to handle and manage. So I'm going to four pieces that are short, that tab, and a couple long pieces. I'm going to set them right there. So I'm going to take that tab again, and I'm going to tape it, that tab to it right on that side, and turn it over. Tape that tab on this side. Maybe the starboard and the port side of the boat. And then I'm going to go and do the same thing on the back. So I'm going to get my piece of tape and tape here. Bring that around. Open that up and push that little bit tab in. And I'm going to go down a little further with a little more tape. Put it here. Just press it around on the other side like that. Hold that together, and again, bringing that tab around on either side like this. And take it with a piece of tape, taping it to one side, and taping it to the other side. So this gets your basic shape of your canoe. But one of the things that we're missing is still we need these thwarts right here like this. And those, and the paddles are right here. So I'm going to cut these thwarts out. That's a pretty simple thing to do. Pretty much just cutting straight lines. These are extra long because we each are going to fold our canoe and tape it a little differently. I want you to be able to cut the right size, so you don't want to lose these things. Keep them like that. So there's six thwarts, six, or they're also called crossbars on a canoe. And there's six of them across it. They're evenly spaced. That give the canoe frame more stability. and something to rest your hands on when you don't feel like paddling, I think. Let's see, I've got two more here. I'm going to keep my crayons. I'm going to put my crayons back away because I'm done coloring. With a little bit of writing on the back, so you want to keep them upright. Now I'm going to take these and I'm going to tape one edge of them. So I first will go ahead and cut myself some more tape. I'm going to need 6 for each side, 12 pieces, but I think I'll just run off 6 little pieces right now. Take my thwart, I can start anywhere. But I want to tape that to this edge of the gunnel. So there it is, it's taped on there. And the hard is pick up. And again, I'm going to tape this one on there. Is that easier to see when I swing it around over the table? I should. So I'm going right in between the two red spruce root lashings on mine. That's the advantage of coloring them slightly different there. Helps you out in this step. I'm going to put them up here, at the front, and two more at the back, it looks like. I missed one of my roots, turning it red. No matter. I'm satisfied with the way it was decorated. There we go. Okay. So you see how they're all hooked on this side. Now I gotta do the other side and cut them. So I'm gonna cut myself a little more tape here. Take this and bend it and bring it over to this side, kind of measuring how long I want it, and then bend it. And then I'm going to cut the excess off. Just throwing that away and put a piece of tape there. So there's my first thwart. So I'm going to bend this one, come over to this side. And it is loosely, not pushed too hard on the canoe, so it stays, keeps its shape. And tape it on that side, just like that. I'm going to bend this one. Bring it over to this side. Bend it again. Simple. A little bit of work to putting the boat together. Pretty fun little toy when you're done. We're thinking it's just, this one's just out of paper, but what could we do to make it waterproof? We might consider actually covering that whole canoe with tape before we put it together. Or we could come up with some kind of a warm wax to paint over it. variety of things we can do. So here's our basic canoe. Now all we have left to do is make the paddles. So I'm going to cut these paddles, just the bigger rectangles. You'll notice that this is the back of the paddle and this side's the front of the paddle, and we have two paddles. So first thing I do is cut this paddle out. And if you don't care if you have a front or a back, you could make four paddles if you wanted to. But I'm going to fold this in half. Yes. So I have a two-sided paddle made out of wood. And then I'm just going to cut out the shape. So. Two-sided paddle. I'm going to tape that together. Just like this. So I'm going to tape that together. I'm going to put one more little piece of tape on the handle. Here. So that it kind of holds together. My paddle. So then I would make the same thing out of this one until I have two paddles for this canoe. So that completes your Athabascan birch bark canoe.